Good morning, super goobers, enthusiasts, ophthalmologists. Today we're just taking a cruise as usual. A little bit sunnier and hotter than it's been in a while. We're just gonna kind of wing it as usual. My brother's Volvo. Look at that one, it's not a turbo. Oh. So a few people have asked me to do a walk around and explanation of the different modifications this bike has. All fairly simple, straightforward stuff. The only quasi-difficult part is, I guess, the wiring for the new battery and controller. But it's really just matching up wires. I've had a long history of, you know, mechanical stuff on cars and motorbikes and stuff. But still, even then, it's not really that difficult. I would suggest to anybody who wants to do this conversion and do it themselves, because seems like nobody wants to work on these bikes as far as a bike shop goes. Either they don't know how, or they just don't want to because of liability. What you can do is grab yourself some 10 and 14 gauge wire, a soldering iron, some solder, some flux, and practice. That's all it really takes. Now, I didn't learn how to do this stuff overnight either. Just a matter of getting stuck in and trying it yourself. If you decide you don't get it, or you can't get it, which is completely understandable, then you haven't messed anything up. You still got a functional bike. There's always the risk versus reward thing as well, you know. I kind of felt like this is something I had to do to learn these bikes a little bit more as well. This the wrong way. How about that? Tesla's everywhere. Definitely parked this bike in the panel gap on those things. paying attention to that. Right in the ding dong. I think I'll go sidewalk. Oh. Ah, it tastes pennies. That really sucked. Karen in the sequoia there is not paying attention, so. I'm gonna ride through here because I've always wanted to. Garbage truck. Get behind something just as equally as garbage. A Nissan Altima. Of course, it has a burnout taillight and no third brake light. And spray paint on the door. By that lake from the other day, the scenic retention pond. Loop-de-loo around these guys. Yep. might think I'm staring at the lady. No, I'm staring at the gorgeous dog taking a dump. Yep. Yep. Beautiful dog. Big dogs always look so magnificent when pinching a little. And I'm going exactly the opposite way from where I was before. Alright. I was looking for the Wonder Bread place. Well, old Wonder Bread place. Oh, that's where it was. This building, I believe, used to be the old Wonder Bread place. Now it's apartments or condos. Everything has turned into. Hi. I honestly say I don't think I've ever been down here. Either in a car, on a bike, or as a kid. One thing you always learn, those of you who are new to this, whoever has the most lug nuts wins. Seeing as we have zero lug nuts, we do not win. Garbage truck, plethora of lug nuts. Doesn't matter if you think you should have the right of way or not. It's very similar to maritime law. You know, where all the small boats have to yield to the large boats. So larger vehicles cannot turn, they cannot brake as well as you can. Dip onto Davis Island here in a little spot that I haven't explored in probably about 20 years or so. Just hate getting onto Davis Island from where I'm at. Oh, that's enough of that. These brick streets always look really pretty. Until you have a car with really low suspension or coilovers or what have you, or a bike with no suspension whatsoever, you really not enjoy their beauty as much. not like this sidewalk's any better. Ow. Alright, well, let's try and not die. Maybe. I'm not sure if it's on this street or not, but I think Jerry Jeter's old place used to be around here. I think he sold it. I don't know whose it is now. We're doing super good on battery today. Some of these old style homes still here. Everything's gone to these big McMansions. Oh, the porches is old. Well, sidewalk it, why not? Immediately dip back into the neighborhood. Don't really feel like stomping. Ooh, nice old hard body. Can't tell if that's one house or many people's houses. Oh, I do want to see that scout down there. I think it's a scout. I can almost guarantee you that most of these places have had water in them. Lambo. Bronco! That's pretty badass. of these places I haven't been around since I was in high school many moons ago. Sweet though, we looked at each other. Aww. We've got a decent amount of battery. I think I might go down by the airport. This haven't been in a long time. Give the bike a little picnic. Controller's not heating up. Somebody die on Thrill Hill. They call that Thrill Hill. I don't know if they still do. One of my friends hit that tree in a Scirocco. I think he was a passenger, but almost killed a bunch of people. This place is called Seaplane Basin Park. Are there seaplanes in this basin? I think I want to check, but... Spot. into position and see if we can catch this guy up close. Getting a nice landing. Or a nice little touch and go router. Oh, you get across the field. Right here for him. Oh yeah, he's coming in for another one. Good, good, good. There he comes. Wow. Wow. Tokyo drifting it in. That is awesome. Hell yeah, man. Almost butter. Good job, buddy. I think that's the last one he did. I'm glad I got up here. Out here then. Very rarely make it out towards the end over here. Let's go on this little bike path since they went through the effort to make it for us. Thank you. when all those cars that pass me have to sit in traffic. My plums punished on a sidewalk. I really don't know who won that one. Alright, half battery, that's enough to get home. Beating on it. Still think the C7 is the best looking Corvette of recent years. Not a huge fan of the C8. Got some really weird angles. The rear three-quarter view just, can't get behind it. Well, no pun intended. Why is it always Audis? Why? Why is it Audis? Indication of their intention. Over here, it's filled with gravel and glass and nails. Really not all that interested in walking 3.5-4 miles to the house if I get a flat. Back on beautiful Bayshore. I managed to bring you guys out here when it was actually sunny. lumbered. Stopping on low battery. Even though I pedal, still kills it. Bike just wasn't meant to have a 200-pound person on it, I don't think.